Right?
Yes, my name is Rohan Hector. I'm from the Anti-Embargo Football Association. I'm the General Secretary. I just had a marvelous tour of this facility, and I think this is a seminal moment in the history of football in the Caribbean. Having a facility like this that we can now play multiple team tournaments from various parts of the Caribbean. We're looking forward to being able to coming here in Trinidad and Tobago, learning not only from the infrastructure development, but also from the football development side. And I think this facility and what the TTFA is planning is a brilliant step in that direction. Quite often we find ourselves having to travel to the United States and to other places to play tournaments, which becomes rather onerous on our economic position. So we think something like this, where we can come and play these tournaments in places like Trinidad and Tobago, and in the future in Antigua and Barbuda and other places around the Caribbean, I think is a very important step for football development in the Caribbean as a whole. And I mean, we're going to learn from this. We're going to get some information to see what we can do, because we are now building our facility. And one of the next steps is for us to build our dormitory and gym and a number of other things. And from the technology that's being used here, I think there's some of it that we can apply in Antigua. Except that we have some concerns, but the good president and the GS has assured me that it can withstand the hurricane forces that we often have to face in the Leeward Islands and the Lesser Antilles. So I think, other than that, I think this is a good learning lesson for me personally, and I will take it back to our association, certainly, because we are in our development stage at the moment.
Any questions? So you are basically impressed with what you're...
Impressed is something you say when you see a beautiful woman, and you see a lot of that in Trinidad. But impress is not the word, I think. I think this is groundbreaking. This is what you need. This you can see being important for the development of Trinidad and Tobago football, but even wider than that, for the rest of the region. I think this is important for all of us.
There's a facility now that can put your local team, your national team, and of course the other territorial and national team will seek to utilize.
Yeah, well, okay, let me put it in brass tacks. It is costing, every time a team from Antigua has to go play in the United States, unlike Trinidad, we have to fly to Barbados to get a visa. And that is costing us sometimes in the region of $70,000-$80,000 by the time we are just taking one team to the US. This kind of facility changes that. That means we can come here and play these tournaments, and that's more money we have to invest in football, invest in our social responsibility with developing citizens, not just football players. But the more we can invest in our people, then instead of investing it all in travel, we're investing it in our people, developing not only great footballers, but great citizens.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
I'm totally impressed with what I'm seeing here today. We speak about income generating. This is the practical exposure to income generating. What we have here is something that should be replicated throughout the Caribbean. It's a facility that takes care of all the needs that relates to football. One of the biggest expense that we have at football is to have people housed in a facility. And most of us have to spend huge sums in hotels. So what we have here is something that, as I have said before, it should be replicated throughout all the region, because it's a money-saving venture, it's an income-generating venture, and so we are really, really pleased to what has been exposed to us here today. Anything else?
So do you compare the situations here with what you have at home, you know, between Trinidad and Tobago and Trinidad?
We have something similar to this, but it is just a minute exercise that we have in Jamaica. What you have is an elaborate exposure to income generating, an elaborate exposure to facility, because you have training fields here, you have a stadium that you have to take care of all your football needs, you have the facilities, rooming facilities, very, very important. You can house your national team, and that's one of the issues that we have in Jamaica. We are unable to house our national senior team. We can also house junior team, but housing our senior team is a problem that we are having presently. And this is something that I'll be taking back to Jamaica to see if we can replicate this back home.
And in terms of funds, one more question. In terms of funds, so you said you have a problem housing and national team, how expensive is it at the midfield?
I think housing our national team takes at least 50% of our budget because it's expensive. Our hotels and a normal exercise when we do carrying our senior team, we have to find at least a minimum of $2 million Jamaican dollars just to house our senior men's team.
That's a side track. Let's move away from this topic. The decision that was made recently to change the qualifying format, I know you being general secretary would have worked closely with the president. What do you think about it?
Well, it's a format that suits Jamaica at this time, but the truth of the matter, it's a very dangerous format. What we have is 3.5, and a matter of fact, 3.25 spots being given to 6 teams. And another 29 teams have to be fighting for a quarter spot. There is no equity there. But hopefully, we'll be able to look at it down the road and to see how best that can be changed.
So why didn't you see it complete?
I don't know, because the presidents do meet and they have their meeting. I don't know why, because probably it was not properly explained to them. And now that they're seeing what is happening, maybe people are having a change of heart.
There's a concern that the CFU, and particularly because of this decision, is not as well, it seems to be fragmented.
I'm not sure about being fragmented. What I am sure about is that the equity is not really there, because as I said, 2019 will be vying for quarter spot. Meanwhile, you have another 3.5 spot for 6 teams. There's no equity there.
Is there a chance to revisit something like this down the road?
There must be that possibility. The truth that we have preached about one CONCACAF, and you know, the president, I know. He listens, and if we all come together and approach the president with our concern, I think he will look into it and to see how best it can be addressed down the road. The good thing about it, we have a situation coming where the amount of teams has increased immensely, and so we'll have 48 teams instead of the 32 teams, so that would give us an opportunity to get more teams from the Caribbean, from CFU, into the World Cup, hopefully in 2026.
Do you have an idea of the process used to come to a decision like that?
Well, consultation probably took place. I'm a young general secretary, so I wasn't privy to most of those probably meetings that they had. But it is where we are, and we have to make the best use of what we are in doing now.
Your president was quoted as saying he supported that move.
Obviously, as I said, this sort of situation is geared towards Jamaica because we are in the top 6, but there is a chance of us dropping out, so we have to maintain our position for us to be able to qualify for this World Cup.
Okay. Thank you. Could you please view this facility, Income Generation Hotel, Home of Football for TTFA? What are your impressions on what you've seen yesterday?
I think it's an excellent initiative. I think this is a model for other associations throughout the Caribbean to follow. We're always spending huge sums on accommodation for national teams and for camps. And this is an example where, you know, you not only can save money, but the location is ideal as well for income generation. We have swimming next door, the velodrome. So it's a facility that I believe can be used as an income generating facility to help sustain the association for a long time coming. We always crying out for funding. I mean, FIFA supports us, but we always crying out for funding. When you have to facilitate 30, 40 people with a national team, it is always very costly. So initiatives like these, I'm impressed. Very impressed.
You're a Trinidadian person, a lot of coaches and backers at the moment. Where is this program at this point in time?
Well, it's still pretty new. Latifi has been with us for a couple of months, but I think he's Caribbean and he has hit the ground running. He just came back with the under 23 team from the USVA with some impressive results, and I think he'll do well. Our technical director, he in conjunction with Latifi has been working on some programs, and you can already see that, you know, there's scope for improvement in football and Barbados. So I think he will do it.